Ready?
I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak?
She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor.
Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
That wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen!
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's the best thing. Why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now. Dr. Kloenstein's okay. As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though. Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool. I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter. I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now. What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
I can't help you if you won't trash anything.
I'll trash some stuff. Just not the stuff you found.
Uh-huh. How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her. That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later. Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. I don't know how
to... Shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! Have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver.
You were such dorks.
You're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
be mine eyes, spot two fair pirate wenches. What?
Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project.
5. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, why?
Dude, that was...
so dorky. What were we thinking?
I thought we were lovable. Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. But where could it be? I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens. Wonder if I could still get to the end. People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. Any luck?
Nope. You?
Nothing yet. Chloe? Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year. Where could that map be? People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool. Bingo. Now, didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet.
Which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic!
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
Was? Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver right again, bitches!
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure. Okay. Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. There it is, the dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up. It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it. Just need a few more inches. I slipped and broke this post a few years ago, but Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about. Did Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her. A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings. I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world. I just need a few more inches to reach the attic. I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back. Seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house. Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it. I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate. I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation. It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it. Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last game we ever plan here. The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years. Not bad for an improvised stepladder, but it's still not tall enough. I think that should be tall enough. There is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through. I think I can squeeze through now. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kinda difficult. Keep it moving, desk. Crap. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom. One step closer. This thing is empty. Finally. This is a nice close-up shot. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works. Chloe Price, my best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend, that's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. Did you find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here, we have treasure to find.
On my way.
You did it!
No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar!
Walk the plank. Perfect.
Wait just a minute.
Yarr! You must ask permission before setting foot, or peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet, coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I'll find something to hold it on.
Thanks, Max.
Time to stick the amulet to the telescope. Then that treasure is ours. Score! One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is. If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Chloe, you could never be a loser. Even if you tried.
Oh, yeah. The best friend code requires you say that. It's just... this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way. Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the Seven Seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah. Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait, how am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with... something?
Here goes nothing. Okay, this drawing is supposed to line up with something. I think the drawing should turn the real world into something piratey. Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Okay, take a step right. No, no, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
is not what we buried.
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers! It's me, Bloody Bill the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed, and always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground. Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe. You were really sweet.
Oh man, I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop. This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now. Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff. I'm gonna draw something.
all these memories. I want to look at everything.
Most of these are pretty far off base.
It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead. It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move. It's good to see you, old friend. These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
Holy crap! It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
Keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art. Recording things was so much fun in third grade. This container looks like it could last 100 years. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me. We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house.
No peeking at my work.
I wasn't.
Get out of here.
You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
Guess I should try to. Chloe and I have been friends for so long.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah. I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly. This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Oh, Chloe. You were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once her parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She didn't seem to want to talk about anything serious upstairs.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right? Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon.
Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. God, I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I was trying to tell you this morning, but...
But I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us all day. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so... I just left it alone. You know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Flies on the windowsill. That we are, that we are, that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land, a darkened plume to stay. Hope here needs a humble hand, not a fox found in your place.
leave you one more message. Because I know this was the absolute worst time for me to go. I thought maybe if you heard my voice, it could be a little bit like I was there. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if I never... Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.